Hey, what is going on? This is Rob from Panther. Today we're going to check it out, some isometric typo. This is an old trend. Everybody did it. I just did it now, you know, and it's really exciting. Let's do this. First thing, let's select the type tool. I'm going to select the font. I'm going to type in mango. And select the bold version. Click. Type in whatever you want. Press Ctrl Shift plus Alt, scale it up. I'm gonna make it with caps locks. There you go. From here, we're gonna go to Object, Expand, OK. Select the color. I'm gonna go with a gray color. And I'm gonna go to Effects, 3D and Materials, 3D Classics, and Extrude and Bevel. So this is in the newest versions of Adobe Illustrator, you know, Illustrator 2022. So you should have it like this. I'm going to select here the isometric top from here. You can also manipulate the extrusion depth, if you will. You know, make it bigger, make it lighter. I'm going to go with like somewhere around 50. You can also add some perspective to make it a little bit more dynamic. Don't exaggerate. I'm going to go with 11. Click OK. From here, I go to Object, Expand Appearance. I'm going to right click on Group. And let's see what we're dealing with. Okay, so we got these sort of vectors that we got like multiple shapes in here. So you need to right click and click on Release Clipping Mask. And I gotta go to Pathfinder and click on Unite. If you don't have the Pathfinder, you can go to Windows and select from here the Pathfinder, okay? I gotta do the same thing with these. Right click, Release Clipping Mask. And basically you need to do for the rest of the typography. So I'm gonna speed this up. So it looks something like this. I'm gonna select all and I'm gonna add a stroke. Click on the stroke, go with black. I'm gonna increase the thickness somewhere around 3. So as you can see, we got some sharp corners in here. So go to the stroke, we got the limit 10 and decrease it. It should go to 1. Now I'm gonna select the top letters, select the P, press and hold shift and select the rest of the letter as well. Right click, group, and I'm gonna go and recolor it. And I'm gonna click on the fill here. So we're gonna recolor the fill, not the stroke. So go to the swatches and select some colors. I'm gonna go with blue. Okay, so another important thing is from one side, we should have like shadows. So I'm gonna make the shadows from this side and from this side is gonna be like more lighter. You know, so on the right is gonna be lighter, on the left is gonna be more darker. So I'm gonna select these, press and hold shift, and these also here. So basically I selected the areas which I want to, you know, repaint it as darker. So I'm going to select some colors and now I'm going to select these areas. I'm going to go more artistic this time. And I'm going to select the pink. Looks interesting. I'm going to go with this orange. I think multiple people apply this trick, these color combinations. So from here, I'm going to select, you know, the top blue. I'm going to press and hold Alt, drag it down until they intersect at the bottom. And I'm going to swap this. So now the black is going to be the fill. I'm going to click on the stroke. I'm going to click on the none. But, you know, make sure that the fill is on black. I'm going to arrange this right here. I'm going to right click on and go to Arrange, Send to Back. We're going to go to the Effects, Distort and Transform, Transform. I'm going to type in 200 copies. And we're going to type in here to the horizontal. We're going to move it 0 point. There you go. Click OK. I'm going to also go to Object, Expand. And this is how I make an isometric typography. Thanks so much for watching. And if you're new on the channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you get notified with daily updates. And also check out the rest of the videos at the end. Have a good day. Bye-bye.